So this is the work conducted by Lynsey. This is the title she's provided for us. And she used two different cohorts to analyse the data. First she used Generation Scotland and then also replicated it and UK Biobank. Now we've got roughly 18,000 people within Generation Scotland and 25,000 people within UK Biobank who have both phenotypic and genetic information. And the phenotype was derived from a, in terms of Generation Scotland, it was derived from a clinical analysis using the SCID diagnoses. And this provided roughly 2,500 cases. Within UK Biobank, it was based on a sort of touchscreen questionnaire that was completed by all the participants. And this provided roughly 8,000 cases. We also have imputed data for both data sets, and this gives us roughly 7 or 8 million variants within each cohort. So the point of the association analysis that Lynsey conducted was to test the effect of each one of those variants. And the results of the depression analysis appear as this in a pictorial representation. So what we have along the bottom there, along the x-axis, are each of the chromosomes in turn. And each particular dot represents one loci. And the stronger that loci is associated with depression, the higher up the y-axis the dot will appear. So for example, we've got sort of dot there, which is our probably strongest signal. However, what we're looking for is any dots that go above the blue line, and that's our threshold for genome-wide significance. So for a whole analysis of depression, unfortunately, we didn't find any hits for depression. So that's looking at purely at depression. So what we can do now is try and stratify that. So we can look at recurrent depression, female depression, and male depression. So the results for sort of the recurrent depression, again, unfortunately, we don't see any of the hits going above the significant line, so we found no hits there. For female depression, we did get one hit that was approaching genome-wide significance, however, it still didn't achieve the level that we're looking for. But finally, when it was examined with male depression, we did actually find one hit that went above the line, and therefore we had a genome-wide significant hit for male depression. Now, if we zoom in on that hit on chromosome 3, we can see actually there's quite a lot of loci that have all been pulled up with us, and that's a good sign. That just gives us more confidence in the signal. In the blocks beneath, just beneath that, we've actually got the genes that underlie that particular region. And these two particular genes I've highlighted here are part of a pathway that includes another gene that is involved in serotonin production. So potentially that's quite a sort of, you've got quite good confidence in that being a real hit. Now the other thing we can do with these sort of analyses is, well, we go back to the depression Manhattan plot, as they're referred to, and what you can do is look at how well that compares to another trait. In this case, I've just pulled up the analysis of pulse rate, and you can see, well, what you can do is compare the number of the strength of hits you see in the top slide with that you see in the bottom, and this allows you to calculate a genetic correlation. And Lynsey did this for roughly 200 traits, and of which, though, of those, she found 8 that were significant after correcting for multiple testing, and these are those 8, and they're actually quite believable. There's neuroticism in there, there's depressive symptoms, and actually subjective well-being is actually a negative correlation, but that's sort of what you expect, because if you're subjectively feeling bad, you're going to see that correlation with depression. Also in there is age of first birth. So actually, if you're genetically predisposed to having children at earlier age, you're also going to be genetically predisposed to depression. The next sort of 3 are all psychiatric ones, and you'd expect good correlations with those traits. And the final bottom one is autoimmune disease lupus, which also shows a genetic correlation. So from Lynsey's work, we were able to see there are definite significant genetic correlations with depression. She was able to identify one hit within stratified depression, and that's within males. Now the good news is that we're almost in the next few weeks, we're going to receive the latest release of the UK Biobank data. Now that's roughly 500,000 people, and this should give us much greater power to detect, and hopefully we'll pick up more hits over time.